Frontline World, stories from a small planet.
This is Lugu Lake, lying just east of the beautiful city of Shangri-La in southwest China. To most Chinese, this area is called Women's Kingdom, a place where women do not accept many rules of Chinese society. I grew up far away in Shanghai. I've been thinking of coming here for over a decade. I want to see how much freedom of life a woman can possibly enjoy. After a plane flight and a 7-hour drive, I arrived at the luxury village by the lake. People here are called Mosuo. The Mosuo are a small minority group that has an estimated population of 30 to 50,000. They believe in Tibetan Buddhism and have their own language. Chinese say the Mosuo society is the country's last matriarchy. Mosuo women do not marry in the traditional way. They practice what they call working marriage, a tradition that has persisted for at least 1,000 years. A man walks into a woman's bedroom at night, and she decides if she wants him to stay. In the morning, he must leave. Mosuo children don't live with their fathers. They're raised by their mothers and their mothers' families. Once the media started touting Mosuo society as a free love culture, hundreds of thousands of tourists began coming. Most of the tourists are Chinese, from the Han majority, like me. I first met Cha Cho in her little restaurant bar along the lake. She also has the only internet bar in the village. We became friends. She said I could call her tomboy as others did. And she took me to see a Mosuo performance. Singing and dancing are an important part of Mosuo culture. Now they sing and dance for the tourists every night, unless the rain is too heavy. But what attracts the tourists most are the exotic possibilities of free love. Cha Cho says Mosuo women can have as many sexual relationships as they want. but some tourists insist on taking advantage of their traditions. The women's kingdom also attracts women tourists who are interested in the available men. This is Zhang's second visit here in a few months. She says 8 Mosuo men have fallen in love with her. Today, each of the 70 families in the Luoshui village owns at least a hotel or restaurant. They entertain the tourists together and split the money equally. Since tourism began here in the early 90s, Luoshui has become the wealthiest Mosuo village. But Chatsuo says, if I want to see the real Mosuo culture, I have to go deeper into the mountains. With the help of a local monk, I headed to a remote Mosuo village. Seven hours on horseback, up and down the hills. Only the locals know these roads.
Yeah.
High on the mountain, we found Wujiao village. About 200 Mosuo live here. When we arrived, unannounced, a family immediately took us in. In Wujiao, everyone works for the common good. Families choose the most capable women to run the household. Men help with the farm work. In Mosuo, there's no abandonment. The old don't have to live alone, and the young are taken care of by the big families. Unlike other rural areas in China, where many girl babies are abandoned, here, the young Mosuo women are proud of being girls. Traditionally, Mosuo women can't wear dresses or skirts until they turn 13, when they go through a grown-up ceremony. Then, they can start dating, looking for men they would like to father their children, and they get their own rooms. Latuo was excited to show me her room and everything in it. I've never had that many rings on my fingers. Latuo says she loves to put on rings, but she will never wear a wedding ring. Asking questions about sexual relationships in front of men is an absolute taboo in Mosuo culture. But women can talk about the subject when men are not around.
We
我不喜欢你的意思唱给他听嘛。
And at night, she says if the woman is interested, she would quietly open the door for the man.
天天剧场家里面女孩子家里面一般都是